You are now tuned in to Vuz Speaks, the podcast where we speak about photography and other topics. So let's get straight into it. Okay. What is the goddamn deal? Apple Podcast, Spotify, YouTube, however you are consuming this podcast, how are you doing? Thank you for tuning in to not only the last podcast, but this podcast. It was very good. I listened to it a couple of times and I was very proud of the very first podcast that I did. I was listening to it and I was like, wow, this sounds like a real podcast. Like, I can see myself listening to this if I wasn't myself. And that's kind of all I wanted to strive for. So I was pretty proud and yeah, just happy with how it turned out and the response it got from all of you guys that listened to it and everybody who downloaded Spotify, because it wasn't on Apple Podcasts yet. Then the people who waited for it to be on Apple Podcasts and listened to it right away as soon as it got on there. Hopefully they're both on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Anchor, Google Podcasts, all the other stuff at the same time. This time we're gonna try to work out some of those kinks as we move forward, like I was saying in the last one. But I appreciate everybody listening to that and, you know, just giving me feedback and enjoying it at the end of the day, just enjoying it and, you know, looking forward to many more podcasts in the future. This is now the second podcast. This is going to be a season. We're going to do these podcasts in seasons, and this is the first season. With these being seasons and stuff like that, I have a few podcast topics that I do want to talk about, but as listeners of this podcast, I definitely want to hear what you guys want. I definitely want to talk about the things you guys want to hear me talk about, because it's not only about me and the things that I want to talk about. Clearly, I'm going to talk about the things I want to talk about, even within some of these podcasts that I, you know, take advice from you guys on. So I asked on Twitter, what's something you guys would want to hear in this podcast that I'm doing today? And someone asked, here, let me find it. They asked me to do this podcast on going to college for young creators like myself. That was from Lucas Colt. I don't know how to pronounce his last name, bro, but if you're listening to this, thank you. We're going to be doing your topic today. So first of all, I'm going to start. This is a touchy and kind of a tricky type of subject in terms of what you should do, because I think he was asking like what's some advice for people going to college for creating, or like if you're in film school, photography school, whatever it is. That's what I think he's asking, but I'm going to touch on that in a few different ways. So for one, I'm going to tell you guys my story and how I got to the point that I'm at, because it did involve school in some type of way. And I've never been a school type of person. I've never been one to kind of advocate for going to school, especially for something like photography, but some people do, and that's what they want to do. I feel like a lot of people feel like they need, depending on the type of photography job that you want, you need a degree in photography to get to that point. And I don't think that's always true, especially with the internet being, well, just the way photography and creating like the format is in now, it's very internet based, and a lot of people have your dream jobs just because they posted things on the internet. So let me just tell you my story and how I kind of went about things. So I'm kind of out of breath today. I don't know if y'all can hear me, but like I'm kind of out of breath. I hope that doesn't affect your listening experience to this podcast, but I'm low-key kind of out of breath. I wish Amal was doing this podcast with me, because she has some opinions about going to school, but we'll get her in here on another podcast and just we'll talk to her about certain things, because she has opinions on a bunch of these topics, even though she's not a photographer, but she makes some valid points when I talk to her about some of these things. So going back to me and how I started, I was never a school type of person. I never liked going to school. My freshman year of high school did terrible. I felt like almost every class I wasn't awful in middle school. I was very good in elementary school. But when I got to high school, just something, like, I just lost motivation for going to school. It just seemed very not for me. I didn't like the whole kind of robotic thing of waking up at the same time every single day, going to school for the same amount of hours every single day. Then only having 2 days off, which is the weekend. And it just seemed very robotic, and it seemed like they were getting us ready for life. And if that's what life was, I definitely didn't want to do that. And it kind of just got me out of the mood of wanting to be in school and wanting to do things school related. And everybody in school was just like, you need to get good grades. Like, you need to get good grades because you won't be able to get a good job. And you need to, you know, they're like getting you ready to have a job, like have a 9-to-5 job. Like, that's what's successful in some of these people's eyes, that you, well, you know, the better 9-to-5 job you have, and the more you can climb up the corporate ladder, and the more you do this, the more you suck up to people, the better your life will be, you know, in a sense. Even if you're, and then on the other side of that, it's like you're either a doctor or a nurse or something like that. Things I don't want to be. I don't want to be a doctor. I don't want to be a lawyer. I don't have aspirations to be those things. So, but I didn't know what I wanted to be during that time. So just school just seemed off to me. And the more I got, like the more I went through school, I met Amal when I was in school in 10th grade. And she kind of forced me to do better in school, because she was like, I know you don't like going to school, but like you need to do good just in case. And there was a lot of people around me. Like, of course, my mom, she wanted me to do good in school, because whose parents, especially black parents, don't want their kids to do good in school? Because school, you know, having an education is very important. In my opinion, it's definitely important. You don't want to be dumb or stupid or not be able to comprehend things. But just, you know, coming from a black household, your mom and dad always wants what's best for you. And, you know, it was harder, a lot harder for black people to get educations back in the day. So I can understand why you would want your kids to, you know, get an education, get a higher level of education too, like college and stuff like that. But I just never wanted to do that. Like, I always was like, I don't know what I want to do, but I just don't want to do school. I don't want to go to school. I don't want this life of working my ass off for something I don't want. You know what I'm saying? Like, school is very stressful. Some people stay up for nights and days and hardly get any sleep, hardly eat, very stressed out, crying. You know, school is very, just not something that I was ever trying to put myself through. But I ended up going to college because my mom really wanted me to go to college, which is understandable. Amal really wanted me to go to college at the time when I graduated, which is understandable. I'm kind of skipping forward. I need to go back. When I was in high school, I started getting my shit together when I was in like 10th grade. And I failed almost every class in 9th grade. So it was hard work trying to get back to a point where I'm proud of myself. So I spent the rest of my time in school just trying to get back to, like, tried to get a 3.0, but like it wasn't even, I could have got all A's in every single class and still wouldn't have got a 3.0. But I got 2.7, which was okay to me considering that I, you know, fucked up pretty bad in my first year of high school. But I didn't really care still, to be honest. And I still didn't want to go to college, but I did against my own wishes. Went, didn't enjoy it. I was there every single day, just doing the work, letting time pass by. I was skateboarding a lot at the time, and I really wanted to skateboard. Like, that was my passion. That's what I wanted to do. I was skating every single day before school, after school, anytime that I had off. Like, that's just what I did because that's what I love to do. And I wanted to get paid to do that. Like, that's what I wanted to be a professional skateboarder before I wanted to be a photographer. So that's what I was working towards. But it just didn't seem, to people around me, didn't seem achievable. Like, who actually becomes a professional skateboarder? But to me, I feel like, I mean, maybe it's the millennial in me, but I just feel like if you want to do something, you can do it regardless of if it's achievable by many people or not. And that's just always what I've thought. That's always what I've told people. I told my mom that I'm not going to go to college and I'm going to be successful without a college degree because I don't want to go. And she didn't want me to, I mean, she clearly wanted me to go to college. She let me do whatever I want, which is great. And I love her for that because she's always let me be me, do what I want to do. She always wanted what's best for me. And what's best for me is the things I want. And even if she didn't agree with them fully, she still let me do those things. So I appreciate her and love her for that. But anyway, I went to school. I ended up graduating high school. I went to college for business administration, of all things, just because I needed to go for something. I didn't care what it was. I was just, I need to go. So I went to college for business administration. It was cool, but I just still just didn't like it. Like, I went there every single day. I was sitting classes, didn't make any friends at all. I went to Davenport University. There's a Davenport University is a university, but they have like smaller campuses all around Michigan. Their main campus is in Grand Rapids, Michigan. I went to the one that was in Livonia, Michigan. So it was on, I don't even know how many people went there. Probably like 200 people. Like, it wasn't a large school at all. But I still didn't know nobody. I still didn't talk to nobody. I was just very standoffish, not social with anybody. I didn't really want to be there. So I would still do the work because, like, you know, I was like, I kind of just like, as you grow up, you kind of get to a point like, I need to do something. I had a job at Kroger, which is a grocery store. And I was going to college and everybody, you know, I was a college kid at my job and stuff like that. And just that type of lifestyle just didn't fit me. That's not what I didn't want to be a college kid working at Kroger. Like, that wasn't what I was trying to do, or bro, it was just weird. And people kind of look up to that lifestyle. People kind of, you know, praise that type of lifestyle. Like, oh, you're doing something good in life because you go to college, you got a part-time job. Hey, let's give this man an applause because he's doing things the right way. And that's just not what I wanted to be at all. That's not what I wanted people to see me as at all. So I was just kind of lost and didn't know what I wanted to do. And I just, it was stupid. But that's what I was doing. I went to school one day, and this was before I was a photographer or anything. I went to school one day and I was sitting in my math class. And I was just sitting there, and I was looking around at the people in my math class, and I just thought, like, do I really want to be like these people? Like, if I'm going to do something with my life outside of this, I need to do it now. Like, I can't be wasting my time in college doing something I don't want to do, because when the time comes, it's going to be too late, and I'm going to be upset that I didn't, you know, take the chance and do something that I wanted to do at a young age, whereas it's going to be a lot harder to be like, oh, I want to do something else. I'm 35 years old now, and I got a wife, kids, and a house. So it's kind of hard for me to just let all that go. And, you know, I got bills to pay. So I just knew when it got later on in life, it was going to be a lot harder to like chase my dreams than it would be to do that right now. But it's in a lot of people's heads that you shouldn't do that at all. And a lot of people were trying to tell me that. And I just wasn't going for it at all. And thankfully, like when I dropped out of school, clearly there were people upset. Oh, wait, well, I'm getting ahead of myself again. So I dropped out of school. I was just sitting there in math class and I was looking at the people around me. They looked stupid, just not something I wanted to be. And I just got up and left. My math teacher was like, where are you going? I was like, I'll be back. Never went back to school. Just stopped going, stopped showing up. I was like, I'm gonna do something else. Wasn't even doing photography at the time. My mom was like, what are you gonna do? I was like, I don't know, but I'm gonna find something to do. And I was skating one day, like just skating around one day, a couple months after that, and I hurt my ankle doing a trick. Couldn't walk or anything like that. But actually before that, oh my God, I'm going back. This podcast is all over the place. But anyway, before I hurt my ankle, I was put in the hospital for like a week and a half because I had a kidney, like my kidneys were failing. I had a really bad like UTI and it spread to my kidneys and my kidneys start failing. Like, it was the worst pain I ever been in. And I thought I was going to die. If not die, I thought I was going to lose a kidney because they said I was going to lose a kidney. It was very close to me losing a kidney. It was very infected. And the day that happened, I was skateboarding. So like, I kind of stopped skating after that. After I got out of the hospital, like, it just reminded me, like, skateboarding reminded me of that terrible time and that terrible feeling. And I just kind of like, it kind of just like wore off, like the passion for it, not the passion for it, because I still very much love skateboarding till this day, like a lot, but just, I was kind of scared. It put a bad taste in my mouth. I was kind of scared to like skateboard like that again, because I was skating every day, all day, dehydrated, just stuff like it was. I was very obsessed with skateboarding, and it was just, I don't know. I stopped kind of doing it like as much after. And a couple months after that, I was skating and I hurt my ankle really bad, couldn't walk or do anything, kind of depressed. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna finally buy a camera. So I bought a camera, and that's when I, you know, started photography. But yeah, okay, so I started photography, and I didn't even start photography to be like, oh, this is what I'm gonna do with my life now. Like, I'm gonna use the I'm gonna use photography as a way to pay my bills. I'm gonna use photography as a way, as my, you know, outlet, like my financial outlet. I just wanted to take photos because I've always wanted to take photos, and I never had the chance to, and now I can because I have nothing else to do. So I'm gonna take photos, and that's when I started taking photos. As I started taking photos more and more, the passion for it grew more and more, and just everything for photography in me just started growing more and more. And I was like, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. If I get paid for it, whatever, you know, it is what it is, but this is what I want to do. And it was nothing that could stop me from doing that. I was working at Ollie's. There is like this little outlet, like retail store. They sell literally everything at a discount price. And I was working there. I worked there for maybe almost 2 years, maybe a year. I don't know how long I worked. I worked there for more than a year, though, for sure. And it was 2016. And I was like, I need to take a chance now. Like, if I don't do something now, then I'm going to forever just be working at Ollie's. Like, there's people who worked at Ollie's. They're like 65 years old. And I'm like, I don't want to be 65 years old working at Ollie's. They're miserable. They need this job because this is how they pay their bills. This is how they provide for their family and stuff like that. They're very stressed out about it and stuff like that. And that's just not something I ever wanted to do. I never wanted to be stressed out working at a job where they don't care about me or anything like that. And I definitely didn't want to, I was kind of scared to use photography as a way to provide for myself, because when people start using, when you're passionate about something and you start doing it as a job, you lose that passion a little bit. It's not fun anymore because now you're doing it for a job. And sometimes people take jobs in photography, regardless of what the photography job is, just because like, oh, I'm doing photography and this is something I want to do, but it may not be the photography that I want to do. Cause just because I'm taking pictures of, say, I work somewhere and I take senior photos every single day, that's not what I want to do with my photography. That's not going to bring me joy. Like, yeah, I love photography, but I don't want to take senior photos every, like, that's not what I want to do every, like, I don't want that to be my job. So I didn't want to get into photography, get a job for it, and then lose the passion that I have for it just because I want to be paid for taking pictures, if that makes sense. I just didn't want to do that. So when I was working at Ollie's, I ended up quitting. I just one day was like, I'm gonna quit. I had $200 in my pocket. I was like, bro, I'm quitting. I'm going to LA and I'm gonna live with my friend Zach, and I'm gonna try to make something happen out there. At least try to meet people, try to, you know, do something. That's where everybody goes. Like, LA is the breeding ground for people who have no idea what they want to do with their life, but fuck it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, people just go to LA like, fuck it, I'm gonna find something to do. Something's just gonna fall in my lap if I stay out here long enough, meet the right, you know what I'm saying? So went to LA, hated it, terrible. Just, I don't like LA, just not the place for me. People are very weird. People are very, just not the people I want to be around in life. And I just don't like the place. You know what I'm saying? There's a bunch of opportunity there, but you have to like be kind of fake to get it. And I can't for the life of me be fake just so I can get something and be, it's just weird. And I wasn't fucking with it, but I did meet people. I did get a few opportunities out there. It did make me grow up a little bit. And I'm so happy that I went there, because ever since then, I came back to Detroit. And after like five or six months, I came back to Detroit. And I just had a new just like drive and passion for photography and making things work here, because I love being here. And I'm like, if I'm going to be successful, I want to be successful in my own city. So I just worked as hard as I could every single day. I like breathed, slept, ate, bled. Just everything about me was photography. That's who I was. That's everything about me was being a photographer. And I worked very hard every single day to get to the point of being a photographer and being a freelance photographer and providing for myself and being able to pay for rent and bills and the things that I need to pay for through my photography, and not just photography, but the photography I want to do. So going to LA did help that, but coming back and like still having that drive and passion for when I went to LA definitely helped a lot. And I feel like going to LA gave me that spark to do it here. So I am very happy that I went to LA and that I did those things and made things happen for myself, and you know, found that type of drive and passion that I can, you know, still hold on to this day, honestly. So that's what I did to get to where I am. But the thing is, a lot of people only see, because social media, we only show the good highlights of our lives, the good things that we do. We don't show the ups. I mean, we don't show the downs. We definitely show the ups and we never show the downs. So a lot of people see success, but they don't see what it took to get there. There was very long days where I thought about giving up. I thought about just getting a regular job. I was around people who was like, just get a regular job, or just, and trying to encourage me to just do something else, because photography is not a real job. And now when I say real job, you know, if you're listening to this, I'm putting quotations around real job, because we all know photography is a real job. But to people who don't understand, you know, photography is not a real job. You have a family, you're going to have kids and house one day. How are you going to pay for that with photography and stuff like that? And they just, you know, people don't understand when they can't see it. We're photographers. We see other photographers who definitely make it happen. So we know it can happen for us, right? So that's just where I was. And I don't know, it was just like a weird place. But the thing is, I'm happy that I dropped out of school. I'm happy that I took the chance and going to LA and things like that and of that nature. Now, to go back to if other people should go to school for photography, or if you're already in school for photography, should you continue doing it, and does it help at all? And my thing is, I'm never going to tell somebody to not go to college. If you want to go to college for whatever you want to go to college for, go to college. I personally, me, and I don't want anybody to, whatever, if I'm a role model to you, or if I'm very inspiring to you, or if you listen to the things that I say, the one thing about college that I'm going to say is this: college is everybody's personal choice. Just because I did something doesn't mean I'm advocating everybody else to do it. I do understand that college is very important for some people. For me, college was not that. And I personally wouldn't recommend going to college for photography or anything creative, as long as you could build some type of, and you don't, the thing is with social media, people think you need to have this large following to, you know, obtain jobs and all these things, when all you have to do is just be good and very passionate about what you do. Because I see people who don't have large followings, very low followings actually, doing their dream jobs. And I see people with very large followings still struggling to get jobs. So it's not always about the following that you have, or the people you know, or anything like that. So I don't necessarily recommend going to college for, you know, photography. I'm not going to say it's bad to go to, because some people are better at learning when someone else is teaching them directly, and they can sit in class, they can do projects, they can do all these things. They have access to all these cameras, things they wouldn't have access to otherwise. And college does offer a lot of great things, and college is very good for some people. There's certain things I don't like about creativeness in college, is that it's all up to the professor sometimes. I've heard stories about people who say their professor didn't like this, so they had to redo a project, and certain photographer projects are based on and graded on the personal things that their professor wants and likes and thinks that photography is. And my whole thing is always, photography is something that's very subjective, and there's no rules in photography. I preach that so many times, like, there's no rules in photography. You can do whatever you want, regardless of who or what anybody says. Do what you want, photograph what you want, how you want to do it, and all these things. So in college, if you don't photograph something perfectly exposed or anything like that, you could be marked down. Whereas I overexpose everything, and that's how I like my photography. And I can't have someone tell me that this isn't right. So I just feel like, to a point, college for photography or anything creative, you're kind of held back a little bit. And especially when someone's telling you how you should be creating, that's kind of hindering to the process of photography. Some people like that. Some people don't mind that, and that's good for them. Me personally couldn't do that because I couldn't have someone tell me that I'm doing something wrong when what I'm doing is just personally what I like to do. Some professors aren't like that. Some professors are, but you never know what kind of professor you're going to get at what school. So who knows? But I don't know. Some people can look past that. Some people don't care about that. And some people have better times learning than others will, where I learned everything I needed to learn about photography just by going out and doing it and videos on YouTube and yeah, just trial and error, where some people just want to be taught. I feel like there's certain things, like baseline things in photography, that maybe everybody should know. And it makes sense for everybody to know. But there's also things in photography where it's just personal preference. And you can't really teach or tell people how to do some of these things. You can't teach people how to have an eye for photography or how to see things or what they should be photographing. Some people like conceptual shit. Some people like portraits. Some people like landscapes. Some people like cars. Like, you can't necessarily figure that out, to me, in my opinion, by going to college and listening to everything a professor is saying. You kind of have to just go figure those things out by yourself. And that's what I did. And that's what I try to encourage people to do. If you're already in college for these things and you're miserable, I think maybe taking a different route would be, you know, enjoyable for you, because you want photography to be enjoyable. If you're not having a good time, then it's just going to be hard for you. And you're going to lose that kind of spark and passion for it. For some people, they might not. For some people, that's just how it is. But for me, I couldn't do it. But I think people should go to college. Even if it's not for photography, people who want to go to college for certain things, go to college. I don't, you know, knock anybody for going to college. That's on you. And that's your life. And that's your, you know, your opinions and your dreams and stuff like that. But some people, on the other hand, can't do it. I'm one of those people who cannot do it. So yeah, all in all, I think this topic was to just kind of, I don't know, I want to say he was asking me to, because he just said going to college for young creators, like, and I don't know if that's saying like should young creators go to college, or if you're already in college, like, what should we be doing? So I think just telling people my experience and just where I'm at with it and how I did things is the best way to kind of answer that. So that's what I did. And yeah, that's where we are with that subject. And that's where I am with that subject, at least. That's just how I feel about it. That's how I go about things. And that's how I've always gone about things. If you're not into school or going to school, or, you know, the school kind of atmosphere and things of that nature, then maybe just try things on your own. If you are with going to school, you like, you know, the social aspect of going to college. Well, at least not right now, because all colleges are shut down, right? Because of COVID. So I don't even know how you would do. I mean, I guess photography projects are kind of different right now, right? You're kind of not in the classroom to be taught these things. I don't know what's going on. I don't know how they're going about that, but I'm sure it's definitely different. It's probably for the better, though. In my opinion, I think people probably out there learning for themselves and doing things like that. So who knows? So to wrap everything up and to just, I don't know, kind of conclude this podcast, I kind of just want to say that all in all, going to college is your personal choice, your personal whatever you want to call it, is up to you. I don't think you should get into what other people are doing or saying, or seeing people on the internet do the things you want to do, living your life, living your dream life, you know, having your dream job. I wouldn't let any of that get to you. If you in your heart want to go to college and pursue the things you want to pursue, even if it's photography, videography, because there's some things in college that you're introduced to right away and easier than people who don't go to college aren't introduced to right away and not so easy. There's things people learn in college where like a little bit faster, whereas it might take a little bit longer for somebody to teach themselves how to do these things, which to some people they like and they enjoy that. I, for one, I'm a person who likes learning things on my own. I like failing at things on my own. I like learning and, you know, achieving things on my own. So that's how I look at stuff. That's why college isn't for me. College, all the other reasons that I listed, like, you know, just having a job and doing all these things in life because that's what society wants you to do, isn't for me. So I've never done it and I've never had the, you know, urge to be a college kid or any of those things. So it's not for me. But if it is for you, then do it. Don't let anyone else on the internet or, you know, in your life try to, I mean, you know, deter you from doing those things. Especially, it's very hard, especially like when your parents are saying, oh, go get a job and go to college and do all these things that we want you to do because this is what you're supposed to do. I feel like the times are changing too. Back in the day, like you needed to go to college to be successful in life. Whereas nowadays, you can do practically anything you want to do because of the internet and the way things are just moving. Like everything is so internet based, especially we're seeing this with COVID-19, that a lot of things aren't meant. A lot of people don't need to be in offices. A lot of people can do their jobs from home. A lot of people, we're seeing that a lot of things aren't what they need to, or aren't what they are because of COVID. And it's exposed a lot of things for what they truly are. So I just think you need to choose and decide what you want to do based off how you feel about situations and stuff like that. If people around you are telling you to do something you don't want to do, even if it's your parents, you need to, especially if you're a grown person, grown, you know, a fully capable adult, you need to make your own decisions and, you know, go with the things you want to do. If you fail at them, whatever, at least you will be happy. And you know, you can say that you did what you did. And if, you know, things don't work out, you find a plan B, you find other things to do. That is, life is all about being happy. And I just don't think humans were made to work at these jobs that, you know, they, you know, go to school, wake up every single day, go to school and then go work for other people and, you know, all that other stuff. And yeah, but if that's what you want to do, then that's what you want to do. It's totally up to you and it's totally fine. And nobody's gonna judge you for it, especially not me. maybe I will, but then again, maybe I won't. Who knows? But anyway, yeah, just follow your heart, follow your passions. That's all I can pretty much say. I say all of that stuff to say, do what you want to do, not what anybody else wants you to do, just what you want to do. Yeah, but anyway, yeah, that's probably going to wrap up this podcast. I can't believe how much I like doing these podcasts. I talk a lot. I told y'all I talk a lot. I talk way too much. And I love it. It's just something about talking to people. I wish I could talk to people directly. Like the people who ask me these questions, if I could talk to them directly, tell them what I'm thinking, they could respond. It'd be more of a, like I said, we're going to get people on these podcasts so we can have conversations, because I feel like these topics of flow a little bit better if there was conversation being had and other people was here to you know, kind of have this conversation, especially with somebody like I wouldn't say Amal. She doesn't necessarily disagree with me about college, but she has her own opinions about college and she's very much for people going to college, but she's also very much for people doing whatever they want. Don't get me wrong, Amal, she's very much for people doing whatever they want to do. She doesn't care as long as people, she thinks, actually, I don't know. What does Amal think? I know she doesn't care. And she loves the fact that people do whatever they want. She went to college though. She has a bachelor's degree in biology. So, but I think if she, I don't know, I'm not going to speak for her. I'm not going to speak for her, but I do believe she maybe went to college for something different. Not necessarily didn't go to college, just for something different. So, you know, there could be that too, where you go to college and you do all these things and you realize this isn't what I want to do. That happens to a lot of people. some people go to college, they get a degree in something, then they can't find a job. So then they end up spending the rest of their lives doing something else that they didn't even go to college for. So that's also that. But as far as, you know, going to school for creative things, I just feel like it can't hurt. It can't hurt. I wouldn't do it, but it definitely can't hurt, right? It is what it is. At least you learn something. Even if you get out of college and you start doing something different. But yeah, I don't know. I guess that's up to y'all. But anyway, that's going to wrap up this podcast. I appreciate you guys for tuning in again and just showing all the love you guys have been showing. It's always appreciated. And it's always like, I'm always grateful for every single thing that you guys do for me. And yeah, it never goes overlooked or anything like that. So again, appreciate you guys. Love you guys. And I'm going to see you guys in the next podcast. So yeah, let's get it.